the underprivileged, the marginalized, the stray, the castaways. Who are they? Those we see but have never seen and will never see. Those we hear but have never heard and will never hear. They neither form memories nor do they evoke anticipation of another visit. But they exist. They exist in our peripheral vision. They exist in our blind spot. So what all of us can do is that we can choose to drive through ignoring them. In all fairness, they were born with disadvantages not of our making. Social intervention drive, said for short, does not believe the equation is that simple. After all, weren't we all born with advantages not of our own making? So Sid invites you to take a drive. A drive to be human and to intervene where the balance is tipped. Because nature loves balance. And if we don't choose to do it, believe me, the powers that be will balance out the scales. So we came to one of these places, and I'd like to take you all there. This was while we were making the 500th branch of Akhuwat in Gali Surjan Singh, just inside Delhi Gate, Walled City of Lahore. We met some children there out of school. Nothing strange in a developing nation. What was strange was the reason. These kids did not have birth documents. They were children of dancing girls. They lived in an area taking the name of which is taboo. This is behind the Shahi Mosque, the Shahi Mohalla. And these children, caught between the divine and the debased, expose the decadence and duplicity of our society. Traditionally, this place was for dancing girls and musicians. In their heyday, they were sought after, even respected. But as culture took a back seat, the crackdown of successive regimes, and modern technology where, you know, one DJ and one electronically powered instrument has overpowered their individual talents. So they had to give up their trade. Many moved out of the walled city. Many took to prostitution as their sole way of income. And hence, there were these children who would always have the disadvantage of their true parentage not being recorded on any official document. Now, this is a densely populated area, so obviously, it affected the other communities as well. Plagued by poverty, disease, exploitation, drugs, these children suffered a similar fate. The balance was tipped. And so we intervened with the learning hub. This is a phenomena that intends to take all these children into its folds. Our focus will remain children of unknown parentage, but every child who's on the street will be taken up by the learning hubs. Initially, the scope of our work was very small. All we thought, we'll educate these few children, put them into mainstream, and that would be the end of it. But once we got into the area, things were not that simple anymore. Also, we did realize that it takes a community to raise the child. So we moved into the bigger community to cater to them as well. We were first helped by a local NGO, SHEED, started by an ex-dancing girl. We navigated the area with her. Very soon, the Walled City Authority joined forces with us, and we discovered they just don't restore buildings, they restore lives as well. Akhuwat became our next collaborating partner. Then, the government chipped in. The Punjab AIDS Control Program partnered with us. Right now, Tevta, the Technical and Vocational Training Institute of Punjab, is also in the process of becoming our partner. In addition to that, the union councils, the local CBOs and cluster groups were all taken on board. But you know what the backbone of this project is? What our main strength is? It is you people, the students. Masoom Awaz is a student group that takes care of the recreation of these children. Took them to a carnival. They had a blast and made goodie bags when there was a medical camp organized for the children. Rohil, another run by a young law student, provides them with bags and stationeries. Dastur Khan is going to be taking care of their nutritional needs. Another group of young professionals arranged for a medical camp. I remember this. When they were, all these volunteers were coming through, and my admiration for them knows no bound, because these young kids go and play with these kids, interact with these kids in an area that people fear to tread. One of them said to me, "Oh, ma'am, I finally got permission from my dad. He's kind of worried, and he's given me a list of instructions. I'm grateful to him for permitting his son. I just sent him one message. Dad, no worries. The place has changed from the time you used to go there." So, now the learning hubs is also a participatory development model. The hubs are being run by locals from the area, either in their own premises or their rented dwellings. One of them is a dancing girl, one who rebelled from a clan and now works for the community. One hails from the musician's family. Similarly, our employees. One of them is an old blind woman, a veteran of the field. And when we heard her sing her ghazals, we said, "Would you be a music teacher?" This was her answer, because she has no one in the world. She said, "Aaj aapne meri tanhai ka ilaaj kar diya hai. Today, you cured my loneliness." Now she's learning nursery rhymes, by the way. Another of our health workers is a transgender from the area. One of our social mobilizers has actually performed with Anjuman and her troupe in one of the old movies. So armed with this interesting band, we set up these learning hubs. Now the learning hubs actually has four basic components. One, we have a tutoring center, which will train these children to go into mainstream school. We are also trying to add a gym and a library to it. Second is our vocational center, which with the help of Tevta and Akhuwat microfinance program will help them learn skills and set up their trades. The third is socio-psychological counseling. Also, through this program, not just fighting the taboos that are in society that way, but this way as well, so that we can bring both parties a little closer to each other. Also, we are going to be talking to NADRA how to get citizenship for these children, how to make it less painful and easy for them. The fourth thing, very important, are the health clinics. Now, the health clinics, they will be providing with the Punjab AIDS Control Program and Akhuwat Health Services. They will be working out providing screening, treatment, vaccination, medical camps, so forth and so things like that. Okay. Now, there's something someone told me, that great dreams are never fulfilled. They are transcended. So I believe this, that we will turn the red light district into the educational and welfare district of Lahore. One day, we'll do that. Our long-term aim is to prevent second-generation prostitution, drug abuse, and crime, exploitation. But you know, right now, what we want to do? We just want to give these kids 6 hours of childhood per day, 6 days a week. Every child has rights. Every child has rights to an identity, a right to health, a right to education, a right to learn skills, but above all, every child has a right to a childhood. Let's not deny them that right. And you know, this project seriously has become like battling the Hydra. The moment we swear one head, two sprout. And every day we come across new insights. I'll tell you a couple of stories. You know, you must be familiar with excuses for not going to school or college, the toothache, the fake fever. I bet you haven't heard this one. One of the kids was not coming to school. And we asked the social mobilizer, because we've hired them to bring the kids from home to school, I said, why isn't he coming? And this is what she said. She said, when the dadi, that is the grandma, does not get enough bhang, which is a locally made intoxicant, she becomes too abusive. And so we can't get the kid. So now, believe me, every day we kind of pray that the dadi gets enough bhang, because believe me, a doped dadi is better than the abusive one. Not just because Azan, that's the kid, wasn't coming to school. Because you can hear her to the end of the street and beyond. Another mom came up to me and said, "Nahi gal dasso mainu, enni savere main school le kis tarah bheja bachiyan nu?" And I, being a mom, you know, understood that it's difficult to wake kids up in the morning, right? It's difficult for us to get up, for whether it was for school, for college, for university, and for work. But there's one issue. The enni savere was 1 in the afternoon. That is when our school is, for the peculiar demands that this area has. It's run in that time slot. There are other reasons that children don't come up to school. These reasons, believe me, are best left unsaid. Do you have your cell phones? Could you get them out? Take a look at them, if you don't already have them out, and if you're not texting, that is. I went to buy a cell phone for my kid. Now, besides the cell phone, there were screen protectors, there were covers to protect from everything. Dustproof, scratchproof, impact resistant. The salesperson could sell me all of this to save my investment. I wondered, so many companies, so many people had jumped in to protect this piece of gadgetry. Why was nothing ever done to protect these kids? So why is there no hardware that protects this investment into our future? Inaction has a price. But nowhere is that price so high as is exacted by the streets on these children. I really don't know how to kind of convey this to you, but you know, as I'm speaking and you people are listening, another girl, a little girl, is entering a brothel. Another little boy is graduating from sniffing smut bond to rolling joints to injecting drugs into his veins. Another kid is being molested and abused in a blind alley. Another soul is being lost. So let's not do anything. Let's just not act. Let's not invest in these kids. Right? But remember, tomorrow, be ready to invest in your prisons and in your health services. You can confine these children and these women to the walls of the walled city, but the crime and the drugs and the disease will not stay contained, and this is a breeding ground for that. There's another fact. What goes around comes around. Lose your humanity, lose your compassion, lose your empathy. That is the death dirge of our society and of our race. So I beg you all, act now to save ourselves, to save humanity. Act now so these young faces, they populate our schools, our colleges, our universities, not our prisons, our hospitals, our brothels, and our graveyards. Act now, so these young lives, left on pause, can play again. Thank you so much.